Assalamu alaikum wa barakatuh. Welcome to the fourth video in the Proofs of Prophethood series. Today's video is going to be about a subject that many Muslims are familiar with. However, some of it is overlooked, but not much gets past Al-Qadhi Abdul Jabbar. When the Prophet, peace be upon him, introduced the message of Islam to the Meccans, one of the strongest and most outspoken opponents was his own uncle, Abu Lahab. Abu Lahab not only rejected Islam, however, he harshly rebuked Rasulullah for introducing his message. Soon after, the Prophet, peace be upon him, received verses condemning Abu Lahab and his wife. Generally, Muslims use this correctly. They argue that this is a prophecy that condemns Abu Lahab to hellfire, and it's a prophecy that he's going to die as a disbeliever. However, there's more to it than that. Firstly, if Islam wasn't from Allah, the doors of repentance would have been open to Abu Lahab. Because remember, Abu Lahab is the uncle of the Prophet, peace be upon him. The likelihood of him someday coming to Islam is relatively high. Now, for the doors to have been closed to him, it would imply that these verses came from absolute certainty that he would die as a disbeliever. Furthermore, there were others who had insulted the Prophet, peace be upon him, much more than Abu Lahab, and there weren't any verses that were revealed that condemned them in such a way. Interestingly, some of those people actually did end up becoming Muslims around 20 years later during the conquest of Mecca, when most of Quraysh eventually accepted Islam. Finally, keep in mind that the Prophet, peace be upon him, not only received these verses, but he recited these verses in public. It was an insult to his uncle. However, he remained to be protected by Allah, and as we've established in the first episode in this series, remained protected until the end of the message. I don't really have much more to add. If you enjoyed this one, hit that notification bell, sub to the channel if you haven't already. See you guys in the next one. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.